to rak'at Allah Azza wa Jal and raised her hands to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And she said, "Oh Allah, I say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Oh Allah, I did what you commanded me, so I ask you to give me in return what you promised me. I did what you commanded me. You want me to surrender to your destiny? I did. So Ya Allah, give me in return what you've promised me." This is the character of the mu'min. This is the character of the believer. You do what Allah Azza wa Jal had commanded you to do when Allah tests you. And await for the promise of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala they had promised you. Ayyub alayhi salam is that prophet and messenger of Allah of great example and role model in patience. That it's becoming very common that to say Sabr Ayyub, referring to that great example and role model Ayyub alayhi salam. Ayyub alayhi salam was that prophet and messenger that lived in comfort, that lived in extreme wealth. He had 7 boys and 7 girls, and he was extremely wealthy, and he had 1 wife. Then Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala put him through the test. What was the test? His 14 children, 7 boys, 7 girls, were all taken by Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. He was extremely wealthy, so Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala took all his wealth away from him. And not only that, he was healthy. Allah made him so ill and so sick that people would not even go near Ayyub alayhi salam because of his illness and his condition. So being so wealthy to being so poor, so healthy to be so ill, from having a number of children, 14 kids, 7 boys and 7 girls, to no children, and he had his wife only. And Ayyub alayhi salam is in that state for years. 17 years and Ayyub alayhi salam is in that state. His wife will come up to him and say to him, Oh Ayyub, we can't handle this test anymore. Oh Ayyub, this calamity is going beyond its limit upon us. That she will work during the day just to sustain herself and her husband. That at the end she went and sold her own hair just to bring some income to Ayyub alayhi salam. And Ayyub alayhi salam got angry from her when she said, "We cannot handle this test anymore." He said, "How long we were in comfort for?" She said, "For 70 years. He said, "I am too shy to raise my hands to Allah after 70 years of test. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala gives me 70 years of comfort, 70 years of wealth, 70 years of health, 70 years of happiness. Now after 70 years of calamity and hardship, you want me to raise my hands to Allah and say, Ya Allah, I can't handle it anymore?" But then Ayyub, what did he say? He said, "Rabbi, inni qad massani ad-durr wa anta arhamur rahimin." Oh my Lord, the harm had befallen upon me, and you are the most merciful. He didn't say, "Ya Allah, lift it away from me. Ya Allah, give me this. Ya Allah, take me away from that." He said, "Ya Allah, you know my condition, and I leave it in your hands because you are the most merciful. Because if that's what you accept for me, I accept that for myself. If that's what you accept for me, that's what I accept. If that's what Allah Azza wa Jal had written for you, then you should accept what Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala had written for you." So Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala took him out of his calamity. And Allah Azza wa Jal gave him health after he was ill. And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala gave him twice as the number of wealth that he had before his calamity. And Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala gave him, beside the 14 kids, 7 boys, 7 girls, Allah gave him 14 boys and 14 girls. But this is the test that Allah put Ayyub through, to see the reaction of Ayyub. And what was the reaction of Ayyub? "Rabbi inni qad massani ad-durr wa anta arhamur rahimin." Oh Allah, the harm had befallen me, and you are the most merciful. If I am ill, it's because of your mercy. And if I'm poor, because of your mercy. Because Ya Allah, you've gave me so much, and I have no rights to object. This is the quality of the mu'min. This is the quality of those that Allah gives glad tidings. That when Allah tests them with a test, they accept Allah's test upon them. And they say, "Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un."